Praise God, praise God. I want to share the word of the Lord in 1 Corinthians 10. I want to read this to you and share what the Lord deposited in my spirit. I believe it'll bless you. And the word of God tells us freely we have received, freely we give. And I just want to freely give this as God has given it to me. And it's it says Israel's history of an example. 1 Corinthians 10. It says, "Moreover, brethren, I would not that you be ignorant how that all your fathers were under the cloud, and all passed through the sea, and were all baptized unto Moses in the cloud, in the sea, and did eat the same spiritual meat, and did all drink the same spiritual drink, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them. And the rock was Christ, but with many of them God was not well pleased, for they were overthrown in the wilderness." You know, I begin to think about how God delivered them from the hand of Pharaoh and out of bondage and out of the enemy's camp. He heard their cries, praise God, and he sent Moses to deliver them. And I began to think about how he delivered them with signs and wonders and with power. And I began to think about, as I began to read this, my mind began to go back to Exodus when the Lord delivered the children of Israel. You know, he sent signs and wonders and plagues. And Pharaoh's hardened his heart. And the word of God has a two-way effect. You know, if we choose not to believe, then our hearts will be hardened. But if we will seek him, we will find him. If we draw near to him, he will draw near to us. And he will begin to open up our understanding, praise God. And I just begin to think about how the word of God has that two-way effect. And I believe that's why Pharaoh's heart was hardened. I believe he chose to be unbelieving, and it just began to harden his heart more and more. And that's the way Satan is. You know, the New Testament says they'll be given over to delusion and believe a lie. Strong delusion, strong lie. You know, the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy. And he wants to harden the hearts of men. Praise God. And Pharaoh's heart was hardened. And I begin to think about how the plagues, a lot of those plagues, they come upon the Egyptians, but they didn't come upon the Hebrews, you know. And I begin to think about how a lot of things, you know, it represents, you know, the coming of the Lord and the last days. And, you know, a lot of things will come up on the unbelievers and the sinners, and it'll be judgment, but it won't come upon those that are covered in the blood. It won't come upon those who, praise God, are blood bought and born again. You know, Psalms 91, he says that it won't come nigh to your dwelling. They'll fall by your right hand, praise God, but it won't come nigh to your dwelling. And it says, "He that abides in the shadow of the Almighty will dwell in the secret place of the Most High." And there's promises given there, praise God, that he will guide you and protect you and lead you. Praise God. Let's read it real quick. It says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him I will trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. And he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings thou shalt trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flieth by day. For the pestilence walketh in darkness, and for destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh to thee." Praise God. And it says that you'll see the reward of the wicked, and there's promises, praise God, you know, if we abide in him. Praise God. And I begin to think about how the children of Israel, you know, they cried out to God, and God sent Moses, and Moses, you know, went, and he began to decree and declare the word of the Lord, and he began to speak to Pharaoh, "Let my people go." You know, and Pharaoh's heart was hardened, and as God began to send these plagues, you know, it didn't come upon the Hebrews, it came upon the Egyptians. And I began to think about how they did the Passover, and how they sacrificed, and I begin to think about how they put the blood up on the doorpost, and the final judgment was that death angel to come, and the death angel would come, and they would take, and they did like the Passover, and they put the blood up over the doorpost, and when that death angel came, when it would see that blood, it would pass on by, because they were covered in the blood. You know, I begin to think about how when the trumpet sounds, And the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those remaining in the air shall be called up, praise God, together. Praise God, we shall be called up to be with the Lord forevermore. You know, we have to be covered in that blood. We have to be ready when either death, it knocks on our door and our journey's over, or when the Lord comes back, we have to be ready. Praise God, we have to be covered in the blood. And I begin to think about how they went through the water. God made a way and he parted the Red Sea, and they went through that Red Sea, praise God. And it signifies baptism, praise God. And it says, praise God, Paul began to write, praise God. He said, and they were baptized, praise God. And it says that they were all baptized into Moses in the cloud and the sea. And you know, the Passover and putting the blood up on the doorpost and then going through the Red Sea represents baptism. And I began to think about how we repent. You know, when Jesus came, he went into the Garden of Gethsemane. He prayed till great drops of sweat turned to blood. And then he went and he had the Last Supper with his disciples. And you know, he broke the bread and he did communion and he broke the bread and he said, this is my body. It's been broken for you. You know, and his body was broken for us. He took the stripes, praise God. You know, he suffered, bled, and died. And on the third day, he rose again. You know, and I begin to think about how, you know, he did that Last Supper and the Passover. And I begin to think about how he said to do the communion. He said to do this in remembrance of me. You know, we ought to remember what the Lord did for us. Praise God. And what he did at Calvary and how he shed his blood. And how and I begin to think about when they gave the, you know, communion, he said, this is my, the bread, this is my body, it's broken. You know, this is this wine represents the blood. You know, and his blood was spilled for us, as his life was given as a ransom for many. You know, but also the word of God goes on the inside. It's the Old Testament and the New Testament coming together. Praise God. He said, praise God, to have the new and the old. And we take that and we put that in us. Praise God. You know, and I'm thankful to be covered in the blood. I'm thankful to have the bread of life living in me. Praise God. And but I just begin to think about how it says they were baptized into Moses. Praise God. And I begin to think about how it says, you know, they had a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night, and how God led them out of that, you know, wilderness, and how he covered them in the blood. Then he took them through baptism. Then he gave them the Ten Commandments, you know. And I begin to think about how he guided them all the way through, all the way through, where they had a cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. And it says that they had a rock that followed them and gave them, praise God. It says, and they did drink from the same spiritual rock, for they drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ. You know, I begin to think about in the New Testament, Jesus lifted up his voice and he cried out, all ye that are thirsty, come. You know, he told the woman at the well, I am the living water, and if you drink of this water, you'll never thirst again. You know, Christ is that rock. He is that chief cornerstone. Praise God. And you know, he is, praise God, the rock that is higher than I. Go to the rock of my salvation. And he's that spiritual rock. He's that well. Praise God. Spring up, O well of living waters. Thank God. You know, he is the living water. He shed his blood for us. Praise God. And, you know, the New Testament teaches us, you know, to repent of our sins, to be born again. Praise God. To confess with their mouth, to believe in our heart, to call on the Lord Jesus Christ, to be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of sins, to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Praise God. And I'm just so thankful, you know, what God Christ did in the Old Testament. You know, it is a shadow of the New Testament and what Christ was going to do in that New Testament. And he is that testament. He is that testator. He is that testament. He is that ordained high priest. Not only is his namesake, but his oath on it. You know, to be a high priest, you had to be ordained. You had to be anointed, ordained. And Christ Jesus, you know, come from the bloodline. Christ Jesus, praise God, it came from the line of, you know, David and the line of Melchizedek, and he is that high priest. Praise God. And, you know, a high priest took position about 33 years old, and that was the age of Christ, you know, whenever he went to the cross. And I begin to think about the Passover. I begin to think about the Passover and how they would have that lamb, praise God, to be slain, and Jesus was that lamb for that Passover that day. Praise God. I am so thankful for the Lord Jesus Christ, and I just wanted to share my heart with you, you know. And as I begin to read this, and I begin to think about what he did for the children of Israel, and, you know, the death, burial, and resurrection, and the blood, and baptism, I can't even put it into words that what God began to minister to me. And I don't feel like I'm really explaining it to you like the Spirit revealed it to me. But then I begin to read, and I begin to think about communion, and I begin to flip the page, and I begin to read over here. It says, the cup of the blessing which we bless, is this not communion of the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not communion of the body of Christ? For we being many are one bread of one body, and are all partakers of that one bread. You know, this began to make me think of unity too, that where there's one faith, one Lord, one baptism. He's the Father of all that filleth all in all. You know, and he said, is it expedient for me to go away that I'll send a comforter? Praise God. And you know, and Jesus walked with the disciples, and he talked with the disciples, you know. And in the Old Testament, the Spirit would come up on them, but in the New Testament, Christ come to fulfill, and the Holy Spirit lived inside. He told his Ezekiel, he said, they have a heart of stone, and I won't no longer write my words in the tables of stones, but I'll write it in the tables of their tongue, the tables of her heart, and I will fill them with my Spirit. That's how we put off the old man and his deeds and the works of flesh. That's how we live by grace and walk by grace. Praise God, walk by the Spirit, not fulfill the lust of the flesh. His Spirit, praise God, empowers us. His Spirit is power. Praise God. You know, and I begin to think about how we are, you know, our brother's keeper. We are to be in unity, praise God. And we are, praise God, you know, in one faith, one Lord, one baptism. We are all partakers of the same bread, the same blood, the same Spirit, the same Father. Praise God. And I begin to think about communion, you know, and what it represents. And I begin to read this. It says, you cannot drink of the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. You cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and the table of devils. My God, my God. You know, we got to make up our mind to serve the Lord. Praise God. Because he's coming back. And we're not promised tomorrow. Praise God. And, you know, eternity's a long time. It's heaven or hell. It's get in or get out. But we have a Savior that's done finished the work. He's done paid the price. He done shed his blood. Praise God. And, you know, he is that great advocate. If we'll turn our heart and lift our eyes towards him, praise God, he'll take what's wrong and he'll make it right. Praise God. And I just want to encourage you today. Praise God, praise God. I just want to encourage you today. I'm so thankful for the Word of God. I can't even put into words what God has shown me. I'm trying to express it. But I pray this testimony blessed your heart. God bless you all.